Today on BigCTV, we are going to review The Order 1886. We're also going to test drive Battlefield Hardline Final Fantasy Type Zero HD and Final Fantasy 15 Episode Duscae. We're also going to talk about the brand new show on PlayStation called Powers. All of that is next on BigCTV. Some legends are told, some turn to dust or to gold, but you will. Hello, everybody. Welcome to BigCTV Season 4, Episode 8. I am Chris, a.k.a. Big C. Got a lot to go over once again, and like I mentioned last week, we got a lot of gaming stuff over the next couple weeks, so let's kick that off with a review that I meant to do a couple weeks ago, just couldn't find the time until now. Here's our review of The Order 1886 for PlayStation 4.
Fine.
Hands up!
Gray?
Don't do this!
I said surrender!
Alright.
Hands on your head!
You have betrayed our order! No one may escape the penalty!
I'm surrendering.
I'm as good as dead already.
The Order 1886 is an extremely cinematic action-adventure game from Ready at Dawn, the developer behind the God of War PSP games. Ready at Dawn does a really good job of making their mark on next-gen hardware, and The Order is definitely a graphical marvel. It is one of the best-looking games on any console at the moment. Unfortunately, graphics can only get you so far. The Order has a lot going for it, a very interesting story involving a secret society of knights whose job it is are to fight lycans, or werewolves. And of course, all of this takes place in the late 1800s in England, so unique setting, unique concepts, everything looks like it's going right. Except a couple things. Mostly gameplay. The gameplay itself, although I didn't find it particularly bad, is basically a generic Gears of War ripoff. The main difference here is Gears of War's mechanics were quite solid, whereas this game, although it has some of the things down right, is a little iffy at times. The other problem is, unlike Gears of War, there are moments in the game where you're kind of forced to do things a certain way. In fact, most of the game, you're forced to do things a certain way. There's not really a whole lot of choice or options here. You just feel like, oh look, here's a playable section between chunks of cutscenes. Which again, the cutscenes are great, but it'd be nice to have a little more gameplay in a game. Like I said, the performances are excellent, the graphics are excellent, the story is really good, but it's a game that relies a lot on quick time events and has very little in the gameplay department to really wow you. Yes, I admit, quick time events aren't as big of a turnoff for me as they are for some people. Personally, I really enjoyed Rise Son of Rome on Xbox One, even though that was a quick time event fest. This one I honestly feel is more so, especially considering there's not much to it besides quick time events. Sure, there's a little bit of gunplay here and there, but not a whole lot else. Overall, The Order 1886 is a solid game that probably should have been a PlayStation launch title. Unfortunately, the lack of gameplay, the kind of genericness in gameplay, and lack of choice really hurt it. Although I don't mind having a few quick time events here and there, there are too many of them, and they kind of water down the whole experience as a whole. I award The Order 1886 a C+.
Pull! Bullseye!
Alright, next we are going to test drive Battlefield Hardline. Now, Battlefield Hardline is a little bit different from the other Battlefield games. Mostly it's set in an urban environment, and you play as a cop or a robber in multiplayer. For campaign, though, it's more of like an episodic cop story. It's really interesting. It does a lot of really cool stuff. It makes you really feel like you're playing through a TV show. But don't take my word for it. Here is our test drive of Battlefield Hardline.
Gaze upon this fine country of ours while you can, gentlemen. It's gonna be your last decent view for a long while. Nicholas Mendoza. Shit. Guy like you's really gotta fuck up the land here with me.
You, might want to secure that weapon, Deputy, before one of these gentlemen takes it off you.
I always enjoy seeing dirty cops end up on my bus. It reminds me, the system works. Enjoy the ride, detective.
Right, this is the one. Huh, shouldn't take very long. What do you say we bag these guys and they'll grab some lunch?
Yeah, okay. I know a decent Cuban place around the corner.
Cuban? Jesus Christ, Nick, you're in Vice now. Why do you afford better than beans and rice?
Seriously? Beans and rice? Why don't you let me order for you?
Here's an idea. I picked the place, huh? I promise, you'll never go back to eating plantains ever again.
You ever had Cuban food?
I think you should take the lead this time, right? Hit with authority, check your corners, find our guy, and we take him down before anyone even thinks about going for their gun.
Yeah, I've done this before.
And not with me, you haven't. All right, let's roll. Use your big boy voice.
Police! We're coming in!
Get your hands where I can see
them!
Up where I can see
them!
Move back and away from the table!
You just knocked on the wrong door.
How about the light out of my face, yeah?
Guys, let's get the hell out of here.
Oh, shit, man. Come on, now.
Okay. Keep those hands on your head and turn around slowly. Slowly.
Under arrest, bitch.
You're making a big mistake.
We're all friends now. Hey, spin around. Nothing sudden.
Fucking bullshit. You know it. This is a fucking joke. I'll be out by the morning, cop. You fucking know it.
Yeah? The pilot coaxes otherwise.
Fuck you!
Oh, shit, it's not a gun! Get down, down, cover!
Oh. Jesus Christ! That got out of hand fast.
What the fuck was that? You didn't check the door?
Hey, I'm the one making arrests. You're supposed to watch the room.
Yeah. Just check the bodies. See if you can figure out what the hell they were up to.
Bingo.
Yeah? What we got?
Wallet. ID. Anyone you know?
Nope. Dead end. Glad there's nobody left to interrogate.
Hey, I was tired of burgers, so I got Cuban. Anybody hungry?
Hey! Stop right there!
Get after him. Go! Go!
I got him! Stay where you are! Hands up! You're just making this worse!
Downstairs,
now! You have pursuit training, right?
Yeah. Maintain distance, try not to kill him.
Get over. We want him stopped now. We're heading north on Mateo, requesting backup.
Oh, come on.
Got so far away. Suck at driving in first person.
Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That
That's the sound of the beast. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the...
You've had pursuit training, right?
Yeah. Maintain distance. Try not to kill us.
We want him stopped now. We're heading north on Mateo. Requesting backup. Turn left on Crocker from Mateo. Intersection clear.
One of the things I do not enjoy about Battlefield is the driving controls are not very good. That's the sound of the police.
You got pursuit training, right?
Yeah. Maintain distance. Try not to kill us.
Get on. We want to stop now. Head north on Mateo. Requesting backup. Turn left on Crocker from Mateo. Intersection clear.
Closer.
Come on, clear it.
Next, we are going to test drive Final Fantasy Type-0 HD. Now, I have never actually played a Final Fantasy game. This is my very first one. So, I'm very interested to see how well this plays. I've enjoyed what I've played of it so far. It's interesting, so hopefully I'll get more used to the combat situation. But anyway, here is my test drive of Final Fantasy Type-0 HD for Xbox One.
The path was not chosen.
They chose their path.
Yes. Not knowing the fear of death.
Having never learned the fear of confronting it.
Still have a ways to go.
Is everyone all right? Have you seen a guy? A guy with a red cape?
No, I haven't. You?
No.
Damn.
Visual!
Kill them!
No.
Oh, gosh.
What's that?
Bird creature thing that got stabbed because it's bleeding. Oh, it's a chicken, basically.
Teacher.
Aww. They shot my chicken thing. You bastards.
Damn. Some
kind of glowy power thing. Suck it.
I'm here. I'm right here.
Yeah, you are. Just kidding. Save that guy. He's about to die and his chicken thing got shot.
Isana.
I guess you're healed now.
It's too late.
I know that.
Why did you even focus on this guy when he was gonna die?
I always thought that your name was weird.
The whole situation's weird.
Machina must have pulled that one out of a hat. think, girl? Is this the end? Machina. Stay strong. Rem. I would have liked to see you again. DJ.
Jeez, you haven't died yet?
I'm glad that you're here with me. No. I don't want to die.
Somehow he's not gonna die, they're focusing way too much on him. This looks more in-game.
Zero here.
Good. The comm arrived safely. Praise be unto the warrior who lost his name.
Fire!
Draw your weapon and attack.
Why couldn't I use magic?
I am Kurosame. I'll be your CEO.
Die. Ha! Beat it. Locked on fallen enemies. Okay.
Your objective, locate the Empire's crystal jammer.
Cool.
Then neutralize it to restore the crystal.
Seal the exits!
Tilt right and left. Alright.
Understood.
May the crystal guide you.
Interesting. Active leaders. Locked on target, a color mark indicates vulnerability. With the yellow mark, you can deal red mark to instantly kill.
Ooh.
Fire! Circle to the left!
Victory! I win! Fading enemy starts to play with your balls.
Please stop!
Yeah, I'm healed. Sign button to begin casting the spell, then release it to attack. For some spells, one button down longer may result in stronger magic. Okay.
First, utilize the central lift. Take it up to the airbay and investigate the military flagship that's down there. The Dominion's fate is in your hands. May the crystal guide you.
Was that?
Good question. Let's go run up the stairs.
We've spotted the enemy unit preparing to engage.
Get in position.
Prepare for landing.
Queen here. What is it?
Just testing the line.
Keep the lines clear of your nonsense.
Nonsense?
What about you?
The operation is proceeding as planned.
Same here. Sink, what's your status?
Die.
Everything's very smooth over here.
Eight? Well, sounds like we're on schedule.
Die. Got him.
Okay, so next we're going to test drive a demo. Now, we've done that before. It's not the first time I've test-drived a demo. But this one's a little bit different. This is Final Fantasy XV Episode Duscae. Why this is an important thing is Final Fantasy XV isn't due out till at the earliest later this year. At the latest, probably next year. That one's probably more realistic. But this is a playable slice, as they call it. Of the game. So this is almost a fully contained little section. It is not going to be included in the full version of Final Fantasy XV, so you could only see it in Episode Duscae, which was included with Final Fantasy Type-0 HD. So, here is our test drive of Final Fantasy XV Episode Duscae for Xbox One.
Thank you.
punk rocker dudes. Jeez, nobody's answering the phone? Come on now.
If only somebody hadn't wrecked the car. God, unbelievable.
Oh, I would hate to be that guy. Oh, come on, don't be that way. You know I didn't mean to do it.
Of course not. Sabotage is far beyond you.
Finally.
It's futile. Rise and shine, princess.
Tremors. Now you did it.
Just call me Titan.
Okay.
Morning there, buddy.
Eyes open.
And he's up.
Not technically up.
Not technically having our automobile repaired and heading to Corsus, then?
No turning back now, Your Highness. Gotta pay his enormousness a visit.
Yeah. Wonder what it's like outside. Wow! Couldn't ask for better weather.
Ah, good day for walking. Aren't we lucky?
Wow. Nice looking.
We're well short of the amount due, I'm afraid.
We need to think bigger, like behemoth big.
Hunting down its horns could get us the money, if it doesn't get us killed.
Wouldn't worry. We're as good as dead without the car anyway.
Might already be a lost cause.
Hey, if Cindy says she can fix it, that's good enough for me.
And since she's gone to all the trouble of servicing it nearby, we need only concern ourselves with one thing and one thing alone.
The money. Simple enough. We hawk whatever we hunt till we come up with the cash, then fetch the car.
Okay. All right, cool.
Knocked. What do you say we check this?
What? Nice.
Hey, take a look.
Hold up a sec.
Huh?
Yes, please train me in combat.
I'm going all out. Just don't get too carried away.
You want to talk?
Okay. Dodge all incoming attacks. Dodging costs MP. Put your defenses in dodge. Alright.
Brilliant.
Ah.
Whoa! Look at this guy!
That was easy. That's awesome.
So good, Prince Charmless.
Nice one. Call me that from now on.
Damn it.
Okay. so good, Prince Charmless.
Nice one. Call me that from now on.
Damn it. Damn it! I'm not very good at this. Down again. What the hell? Why can't I stop this? Suck. Come heal me again, bro.
Not looking so good, Prince Charmless.
Nice one. Call me that from now on.
Damn it, I can't do it quick enough. I either don't do it quick enough or I do it too early. Not good at parrying. Damn it! What the hell? Can I just stop doing the tutorial?
Come on, that's not the prince I know!
That wasn't my style.
What the hell? Come on. Come on! the hell? Come on.
Not looking so good, Prince Charmless.
Nice one. Call me that from now on.
Alright, now this is just getting frustrating. I killed you already, dude. Just leave me alone. I'm done with this. Ah!
That's not the prince I know.
That wasn't my style. Can't stop not.
Finally. Did it, finally. Yeah!
Thanks. I owe you one.
Yeah. Hey, I did it. I beat the tutorial.
Alright, so we're going to end the show today with TV Talk, where I'm going to talk about a new episodic series that is exclusively on PlayStation entitled Powers, starring District 9's Charto Copley. So here is TV Talk. Okay, so Powers. Interesting concept. Basically, it's based on a graphic novel. The concept is it's about a world where superpowered humans, known as powers, exist. And everyone just kind of deals with it. Charto Copley plays a character who used to be a superhero, but lost his powers. So now he's a cop in the division of the police who investigate superpower-related crime. Interesting concept. And sounds pretty cool in theory. It works for the most part. I've only seen 3 episodes of Powers. I believe the 4th one just came out, so I have to check that out. Concept's interesting. The tone is a little uneven. A lot of the superpowers are really goofy and eccentric, and they don't really fit in the dark, gritty universe they're trying to create. Copley does a great job. The supporting cast also do a great job. But I think it's, you know, goofy things like sound effects. There are a lot of sound effects that kind of throw you out of the world that you're in, among other things. So, I mean, it's a good show from what I've seen of it so far. I just wish they tried to hone in on, okay, let's make this kind of gritty and less, you know, mediocre CGI and goofy sound effects-y. So hopefully that will change at some point, but for now, that's what we got. I think it's a gutsy move by Sony to release this as a PlayStation show. Not only that, but it's clearly a show intended for mature audiences, so youngsters looking for a TV show based on superheroes, not going to happen for this one. So if you want to watch Powers, Season 1 will be available for free for PlayStation Plus subscribers. So if you have a PlayStation 4 or 3 and subscribe to PlayStation Plus, guess what? You get the whole season. If you are not a PlayStation Plus subscriber, which honestly, if you have a PlayStation, you probably should be, you can download the first episode for free online. So either way, you get to see the pilot. And I'd say, I mean, it's free, so why not watch it? And if you're a PlayStation Plus subscriber, you get the whole season for free. So that's pretty cool. But from what I've seen of Power so far, I like it. It's an interesting concept, but there are a few things I wish they would tweak to improve the quality of the show. So those are my notes. And that's going to do it for BigCTV Episode 8. I'm Chris. Thank you for watching. Look for plenty more gaming stuff next week. We got 3 new games coming out next week. I'm sure you're going to be very excited to see what we have on those. And I'm sure plenty of other things will come up. So thank you for watching. See you next week.